Good morning, Class 7. I hope you are all fit and well and staying safe today. If you remember yesterday, we started reading this book, The Gruffalo, one of my favourite books. And yesterday I asked you to think about where the fox lived and design your own underground house. I wonder what you had in your underground house for the fox. But I bet it was really, really good. So today we're going to continue the story, finish it off, and then there will be another challenge. So, roasted fox, I'm off, Fox said. Goodbye, little mouse. And away he sped. Silly old fox, doesn't he know? There's no such thing as a Gruffalo. On went the mouse through the deep dark wood. An owl saw the mouse, and the mouse looked good. Where are you going to, little brown mouse? Come and have tea in my tree top house. It's frightfully nice of you, owl, but no. I'm going to have tea with a Gruffalo. Look at him swooping down. A Gruffalo? What's a Gruffalo? A Gruffalo? Why, didn't you know? He has knobbly knees and turned out toes and a poisonous wart on the end of his nose. Where are you meeting him? Here by this stream. And his favourite food is owl ice cream. Ooh, owl ice cream, twittu. Goodbye, little mouse. And away owl flew. Silly old owl. Doesn't he know? There's no such thing as a Gruffalo. On went the mouse through the deep, dark wood. A snake saw the mouse. And the mouse looked good. Where are you going to, little brown mouse? Come for a feast in my log pile house. It's wonderfully good if you, snake. But no, I'm having a feast with a Gruffalo. His eyes are orange, his tongue is black. He has purple prickles all over his back. Where are you meeting him? Here by this lake, and his favourite food is scrambled snake. Scrambled snake? It's time I hid. Goodbye, little mouse. And away snake slid. Silly old snake. Doesn't he know? There's no such thing as a Gruffalo. Oh! But who is this creature with terrible claws and terrible teeth and his terrible jaws? He has knobbly knees and turned out toes and a poisonous wart at the end of his nose. His eyes are orange, his tongue is black. He has purple prickles all over his back. Oh, help. Oh, no. It's a Gruffalo. My favourite food, the Gruffalo said. You'll taste good on a slice of bread. Good, said the mouse. Don't call me good. I'm the scariest creature in this wood. Just walk behind me and soon you'll see. Everyone is afraid of me. All right, said the Gruffalo, bursting with laughter. You go ahead and I'll follow after. They walked and walked till the Gruffalo said, I hear a hiss in the leaves ahead. It's Snake, said the mouse. Why, Snake, hello. Snake took one look at the Gruffalo. Oh, crumbs, he said. Goodbye, little mouse. And off he slid to his log pile house. "You see," said the mouse, "I told you so." "Amazing," said the Gruffalo. They walked some more till the Gruffalo said, "I hear hoot in the trees ahead." "It's Owl," said the mouse. "Why, Owl, hello." Owl took one look at the Gruffalo. "Oh dear," he said. "Goodbye, little mouse." And off he flew to his treetop house. "You see," said the mouse, "I told you so." "Astounding," said the Gruffalo. They walked some more till the Gruffalo said, "I can hear feet on the path ahead." "It's Fox," said the mouse. "Why, Fox, hello." Fox took one look at the Gruffalo. "Oh, help," he said. "Goodbye, little mouse." And off he ran to his underground house. "Well, Gruffalo," said the mouse, "you see, everyone is afraid of me. But now my tummy's beginning to rumble. My favourite food is Gruffalo Crumble." "Gruffalo Crumble," the Gruffalo said. And as quick as the wind, he turned and fled. All was quiet in the deep, dark wood. The mouse found a nut, and the nut was good. Today's challenge is, what do you think might happen next in the story? Does the Gruffalo come back? What about the fox and the owl and the snake? Do they return? You can see now why I chose Mouse. The person to be in charge, Mouse would be the best. He is so powerful because he has intelligence. That's all for today, Class 7. See you tomorrow. Bye.